Hello and welcome back to the 2019 BioInvestor Forum here in San Francisco. I'm Christine Corrado with Proactive Investors. Joining me right now is Yochi Slonim. He's the CEO of Anima Biotech. Yochi, great to see you again.
Hi.
We last spoke at the Bio CEO in February of this year.
Right.
Remind our investor audience a bit about the company.
Okay. So Anima has a discovery platform called Translation Control Therapeutics, which is the first platform to discover small molecule drugs that control the translation of mRNA as a new strategy against many diseases. mRNA in small molecules has become a pretty hot area recently. Over the last 12 months, we've seen more companies joining that space and actually raising quite a lot of money from corporate VCs, from traditional VCs. A few hundreds of millions of dollars actually went into that space recently. And the reason is that mRNA represents a very attractive new strategy to actually go after proteins that are completely undruggable in conventional methods. Also, RNAi made finally, kept its promise, and finally there are drugs, that came out of that. But these drugs are not small molecules. So the idea that you could do the same with small molecules is super attractive today.
What have you been up to since February?
Okay. So our strategy is unique in that area because we are the only company that goes after the translation of the mRNA.
Mm-hmm.
And really what comes with that are a few unique advantages of the approach itself. And this actually can be seen in the progress in the pipeline of the company. So the first thing about our strategy is that we can actually discover compounds that are not only decreasing but also potentially increasing proteins. This is completely outside of the scope of conventional drugs today, because all the diseases where the problem is underexpression of a protein, they are actually virtually untreatable.
Mm-hmm.
Because what drugs do, they bind to the protein and inhibit it. But if the problem is lack of protein, there is nothing to do.
Mm.
With our strategy, it is possible to increase, not just decrease proteins, in a specific way. The second advantage is tissue-selective drugs. This is a completely new paradigm that we actually demonstrate in our pipeline in multiple programs. The ability of drugs today, if you consider what is a good drug, it's a drug that binds to the target, mm-hmm. binds well to the target, but with that comes the problem that it will bind to the target everywhere in the body.
Mm-hmm.
So systemic side effects are the downside of conventional drugs.
Mm-hmm.
But when we look at the control of the translation of mRNA as the strategy, cells have mechanisms that control the translation of the same protein differently in different tissues. And those are the targets of our drugs. So as a result of that, we were discovering consistently drugs that are working in just one tissue against the same protein, but they are not going to work elsewhere. And this is huge because this means that those drugs are safer. They are like guided molecular missiles. They are finding the disease and they work only there.
Hmm.
Let's put this in the context of the pipeline of the company. So our lead program is in lung fibrosis. Last time that we spoke, we were in the heat optimization. Now we are in lead optimization phase.
Wow.
And actually those drugs demonstrate exactly the aspects that I was talking about. So we have compounds that are active to reduce collagen in the lungs, and they are still not working in the liver or the skin.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody has that strategy. Actually, nobody has a strategy that goes after collagen production, as this is the most visible phenotype of the disease.
Except for you.
But we can actually go after that and go after that in a tissue-selective manner. Think about it. If it wasn't tissue-selective, that strategy would actually collapse because it would mean that you are going to stop production of collagen across the body.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that these drugs are tissue selective means that we can expand that strategy to liver fibrosis, to kidney fibrosis, and we can actually still keep the tissue selectivity across different indications. We compared our drugs to some existing commercial drugs for pulmonary fibrosis, as well as to some molecules that are in phase 3. And guess what? They are extremely more effective in elimination of collagen than those drugs because they are targeting the root cause rather than going indirectly after some pathways and pathways that are completely ineffective in elimination of the collagen eventually. So that's about the lead program of Anima. Talking about progress of the pipeline, let's talk about the oncology program. So we have a program against a very well-known undruggable protein called CIMIC. Mm-hmm. There are two best well-known undruggables. One is called KRAS, it's a mutation. And CIMIC, it's about overexpression of that protein. It exists in like 70% of the cancers and has been a target for the last 30 years, but nobody could do anything about it because chemically, the structure of that protein does not lend itself to conventional small molecule drugs. Mm-hmm. What we were able to do is to discover translation inhibitors of CIMIC. So they actually inhibit the translation of the protein. Within 4 hours only, they eliminate most of the CIMIC from cells. They are, again, demonstrating very unique profiles. For example, they are killing all the cells that are overproducing CIMIC, but they are sparing all the cells that are not overproducing CIMIC. This was tested across 17 different tumors. And all our drugs, also we test them that this is the mechanism of action. They are actually controlling the translation. They are not working to control the transcription, which is a different strategy altogether. So they demonstrate that capability as well. That program is right now approaching the lead stage.
Great.
We have two additional programs. As you remember, one is the RSV. Again, this made a lot of progress and is closing. Now it's close to the lead stage. And finally, we have the Huntington disease program. That one is actually finishing now the heat optimization phase. And we are expanding it to a whole new area, which is called REN diseases, repeat-associated diseases. These are diseases where the problem is actually in the mRNA itself. It has many repeats of triplets, what are called, or those are actually perfect fit for our technology. We can see and monitor the translation of those faulty mRNAs and discover drugs that are basically controlling the translation to restore basically to a healthy state.
We last spoke about your partnership with Eli Lilly. How's that going?
So the partnership is going extremely well. Eli Lilly is actually a great partner. I would say of all the pharmas that we've seen, they are one of the best in terms of research. They have great capabilities. The teams are working together in complete collaboration. Lilly is continuously also funding Anima in that collaboration, which is putting Anima in a very strong financial position. We did our A round. Mm-hmm. That was 2.5 years ago, 20 million from private investors. There are no VCs involved in Anima today. We still have like $30 million in the bank because of that collaboration with Lilly, and they are continuing to actually fund the research going forward. We're expecting some milestones by the end of next year, which could actually add to that substantial amounts of money. Mm-hmm. But as a matter of fact, Anima is seeing a lot of interest, inbound interest currently from investors. So we are considering to do another round, maybe the beginning of next year.
Well, Yochi, great to hear about your progress. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.